Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome back to the loot. I mean, to room 9, the largest classroom in the region. It's Dr. Sanders in here today representing St. Louis. I'm from the loot, and I'm proud. I also had the chance to read some wonderful books. We had the chance to read wonderful books this week from people from St. Louis. So I had to wear my shirt and, as usual, my hat. Remember, I'm Dr. Sanders. I work at Adams Elementary and St. Louis Public Schools. And I'm here to teach a little pre-K and K, ELA and math. But guess what, boys and girls? It doesn't matter how old you are. I hope and I know you can learn something. And it doesn't matter if you're what? 2 or 102. You will have some what? Fun. F-U-N. Fun. So let's go over our objectives for today. And in math, we're going to recognize numbers up to 100 and review some shapes. In ELA, we're going to answer some simple comprehension questions as we look at another book with the same illustrator that we read the other two books by. Okay, so you ready to get started? Let's get it started. Let's start. Okay, I'm sorry. Here we go. First, we gotta get started by taking my what off? My hat, that's right. Take my hat off, or should I just turn it around? Take it off? You know, I like the St. Louis sign though. All right, let me take my hat off so we can get started. Today, we've been over these last few months this fall. We've went over a lot of names, a lot of my friends' names. And we talk about the season of giving, right? We've been talking about giving. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try these next 2 days. I'm going to try to show everyone's name that we've been going, everyone's names that we went over so far this fall. All right. And if it's your name, you just throw your hand and say, yep, that's me. Okay, everybody try it. Yep, that's me. I didn't hear you. You gotta say it a little louder. Yep, that's me. Okay, so here we go. Here we go. Let's see. Whose name is that? Dejan. Yep, that's you. Olana. Yep, that's you. Alon. Yep, that's you. Zamir, yep, that's you. Jace, yep, that's you. Mariam, yep, that's you. Aubrey, yep, that's you. Brandon, yep, that's you. Latrell, yep, that's you. Riley, yep, that's you. Parker, yep, that's you. Cheyenne, yep, that's you. Emma, yep, that's you. Lydia, yep, that's you. Tariq, yep, that's you. Amaya, yep, that's you. Nakai, yep, that's you. German, yep, that's you. Jermaine. Yep, that's you. Gerardo, yep, that's you. Gillespie, yep, that's you. Julieta, yep, that's you. Nia, yep, that's you. Also, boys and girls, you can try sounding those names out with the beginning letter, right? Let's do a couple more for today, and then we'll move on. I know you're like, whoa, this is interesting. These people, if you see your name, instead of saying, yep, that's me, say, uh-huh. Say, uh-huh. Let me, everybody try it. Uh-huh. Try it again. Uh-huh. Okay, here we go. Let's do these few names. Here we go.
Yeah.
Here we go. Sicily. Yeah. Huh. Mason. Huh. Aria. Skylar. Justice. Danicla. Danicla. Heaven. Curtis. Paisley. Lexton. Maya. Haiti. Hattie. Lola. And Nia. Anybody count? That was a lot of names we got through. We have a whole bunch more. You want to see how many more we have? Look at that, all those names. Maybe at the end of the show, we'll do some more. Okay, here we go. Let's do our sight words. And these are the last sight words. The last 2 days we went over them. These are the last ones we have. So tomorrow, we'll have time to go over some more names. Here we go. Who's that? What word is this? My goodness, there were a lot of names in room 9 this year. Let's spell my. My. M-Y. My. What word is this? She. She is a wonderful student. She. S-H-E. She. And whose word is she? What name is this? On. Let's spell on, O-N, on. He is on TV. What word is this? Two, spell two, two, T-W-O, two. What word is this? They. I'm sorry. There are two people in the room. Before you were three, you were what? Two. What word is this? They. Let's spell they. T-H-E-Y. They. They are so happy and excited to be in room 9. Yeah, dog. What word is this? A. We are looking for a person who loves to give. What word is this? Wear. What are you going to wear when it snows outside? What shoes are you going to wear? What shoes do you choose? What color, what word is this? Red. I have a red die or a pair of red dice that I can play dice with. Red. What number is this? Jump. What word is this? Jump. I knew somebody was going to catch me. It's jump. J-U-M-P, everybody jump and kick the air. What word is this? Mat. Mat rhymes with hat. Mat. During rest time, you go lay on the mat. New. Let's spell new. N-E-W. New. We have a new person in school. In school. Let's spell in. In. I-N-N. All right. People are still continuing to celebrate Hanukkah. I hope you're having a good week celebrating Hanukkah. Remember our other holidays? Remember, are the holidays about getting stuff? No, you get stuff, but it's about what? Giving. It's about giving. And I gave everybody a chance to see their names, hopefully. And also, the author of this book, Asia LaStar, she actually gave these books to me so I can share them with you. So I am sharing something she gave me. She gave them so I can share them with you. So I'm giving it to you like she gave them to me. That's very important. This book. Before we read our book, everybody please stand. Jump up and down 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do this 10 times. Okay, you ready? Oh, count 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right. Raise the roof. Okay, let's raise the roof eight times. Go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Let's nod our head 10 times, but we're going to do it in Spanish. Go. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Let's floss. Let's floss 7 times. You ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, let's sit down on 3. 1, 2, 3. Up, down, up, down. Sit right down on the ground. Or the chair, or the couch. But make sure you don't jump on the couch. Wherever you can sit. Today, we are going to read a book called Jalen's Going to Be a Barber. What is a barber? What do you think a barber is? What is a barber? Have you ever been to the barber shop? What do they do at the barber shop? Yes, they cut your hair. So a barber is the person who does what? Cuts your hair. So what does Jalen want to be? He wants to be a barber. Look at him getting his hair cut. He got some locks. He gonna cut the locks off? Maybe he's just sitting in the chair though, right? All right. And the author of this book is Asia Lestar, and it's illustrated by Unishka Dunuvila. I'm gonna get the name right. And we're gonna take a look at the pictures and just take a look at the pictures and how they fit the book. And I am reading this with permission from Miss Lestar. And what am I? I wanted to share something. Yesterday, Adara read this book, Which Shoes Shall I Choose? And in the book, it said, Design Your Own Shoe. So guess what? What Adara did is she printed off something, and she designed her own shoe. And she shared it with me, so I'm sharing it with you. This is the shoe that she designed. After reading the book, Which Shoes Shall I Choose? Jalen's going to be a barber. This is the what? Front cover. This is the what? Back cover. This is the spine. So let's read our book. Jalen's going to be, and look at this. She autographed the book. Remember, you can see her on the street. Make sure you wave to her and say thank you. Or look her books up and maybe you can buy them because they're very important. And she's from St. Louis. She's from the Loop and she's proud. Being a barber is about taking care of people. That's what Anthony Hamilton said. It was a bright and sunny day as Jalen and his dad, Mr. Owens, pulled up to Supreme Cuts, a family-owned barbershop. So you really think you want to be a barber, Mr. Owens jokingly asked. Yes, Dad. Being a barber is easy. All you do is cut hair all day and make a lot of money, Jalen said with confidence. Mr. Owens chuckled and said, Son, I see you have a lot to learn. Let's go inside. As they walked in, Mr. Epps, the oldest barber in the shop, yelled from the back, Hey, little Jay, give me a high five. Another barber named Miss D hollered, Don't leave me hanging, JJ. Give me something down low. And she gestured for Jalen to slap her hands. My man, Mr. J, we've been waiting on you all day, Jackie O confessed. Look at the illustration with St. Louis in the back. Jalen loved the attention he received from the barbers. In fact, that is what he loved the most about becoming a barber. He always felt like a celebrity. After a little small talk with the barbers, Mr. Owens walked over to Jalen and handed him his broom. Whenever Jalen came to the shop, it was his job to sweep the hair up from the floor and take out the trash. Ah, said Dad, I thought I was going to do something more exciting, like cut some hair or give someone a shave. Do I have to sweep today? Jalen complained. Son, we have plenty of time for you to learn the tricks of the trade. But first, I need you to sweep this floor, Mr. Owens commanded. Jalen started to... We'll read that one. We'll show you that page. Jalen started to have second thoughts about becoming a barber. As he began sweeping the floor and mumbling under his breath, the strangest thing occurred. A homeless man who noticed the walk-in welcome sign stumbled into the barbershop. May I help you, sir? Mr. Owens questioned. Well, I don't know, the homeless man said. I could really use a haircut, but I don't have any money. Please, sir, have a seat, Mr. Owens suggested as he cleaned off the seat for his guest. But Dad, Jalen said softly, trying not to be heard by the homeless man, he doesn't have any money. How is he going to pay you? He's right. I should have never come inside. I'm sorry to waste your time, the homeless man said, feeling a little bit embarrassed. Mr. Owens insisted on cutting his hair free of charge and reminded Jalen of his sweeping duties. As Mr. Owens finished cutting the homeless man's hair, he gave him a mirror to look at himself. The homeless man felt good about his fresh haircut and could hardly recognize his own image. He thanked Mr. Owens many times before he happily walked out of the barbershop. Come here, son, Mr. Owens said calmly. Sit in the chair. Mr. Owens put a cape around Jalen and began to explaining to him some of the key things about being a barber. Son, being a barber is not just about cutting hair and making money. It is about making people feel good about themselves. Barbers are like artists. They create styles that help people express their own uniqueness and individuality. Yes, celebrities and athletes will come strolling into the barbershop, but everyone who walks into Supreme Cuts is a celebrity to me. It takes a lot to be a barber. You have to be patient, creative, and you have to have respect for all people, even those who are less fortunate or different from you. You know, Dad, I really thought being a barber was easy, but now I understand that there's a lot more that I need to learn. I want to spend my Saturday here with you and the other barbers learning more about what it takes to be a barber, because I want to make people feel good about themselves, just like you do every day. All right, I have a quick question for you. Why did Jalen think that being a barber was going to be easy? Right, because the only thing he had to do was what? Just cut hair, right? Yes. Why do you think he felt that way? Because he always saw his dad do? Yes, probably. By the end of the story, Jalen knew that being a barber wasn't easy. Why do you think he felt that way? What made him change his mind? The talk that he had with his daddy? Yes. Do you think Jalen still wants to be a barber? Yes, he said he did. And who else wants to be a barber? Raise your hand if you wouldn't mind being a barber. Why would you want to be a barber? Yes, to make people feel good. That's why I like being a teacher. I love to see when kids just love learning. I hope you love learning from me. And I hope you enjoyed this book from Miss Angela Starr. Remember St. Louis? Go to ICME bookstore. Maybe you can buy it. Let's do some counting. Oh, let's do some counting. Oh. Count, 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 count with me. I gotta get a drink of water first. All right, let's get my number chart. Let's get the number chart. You ready to count our numbers? Let's go. Zero. Oh, we're not gonna start it. We're gonna start at 81 and go to 100 by ones. You ready? Here we go. Nice and loud. Get some bass in your voice. All right. 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97. 98, 99, 100. All right, let's count from zero. Did you like that? Okay, let's count from zero to 100 by fives. Are you ready? I want to hear all of you count. Let's go. 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 95, 100. Let's write 100. 100. Here we go. Let's count from 0 to 100 by 10. Let's go. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. We did this a couple times. Let's do blast off. That's when you put your hands in the air and we're going to count backwards from 10, or just like subtraction, right? So we're going to start really low and then we get loud at the end of blast off. Okay, you ready? 10, 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Blast off! I'm sorry. Too loud? Okay, I'll bring it down a little bit. Blast off! Here we go. I'm going to point to a number, and I want you to tell me what that number is. You ready? Here we go. What number is this? Oh, my goodness. 4. You all right? What number is this? 23. That is correct. What number is this? A 5 and a 7? 57. That is right. What number is this? 7. That is correct. What number is this?
22.
Yes. What number? 11. Whoa, slow down. That is the number 11. What number is this? That's right. A 5 and a 2. Which two digits? 5 and a 2. Which comes first? The 5 comes first. So that's 52. Guess what, boys and girls? We are not done. No, we're not done yet. What are you talking about? We're not done yet. We're going to go over some shapes. And as we go over these shapes, we have some more names. Because remember, I put my names on the shapes. So we're going to do this and get rid of some more names that we already went over. Whose name is this? Noah. What shape is this? Let's count the sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 sides makes what? A hexagon. Everybody say hexagon. Ooh, whose name is this? Ayla. What shape is this? A triangle. Whose name is this? Ruth. Hi, Ruth. In And how many sides does it have? Pretend this is a point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sides. Yes, that's a pentagon. 5 sides is a pentagon. Whose name is this? Abu. Yes, that is Abu's name. 1, 2, 3, 4. They look like they're even all around. So that's a what? A square. Whose name is this? Yes. J-C-I-J-A-S-I-Y-O-N. It has how many? No, it's not a house. What shape is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, a pentagon. Whose name is this? Christiana. 2 long sides and 2 short sides is a what? Rectangle. Whose name is this? Vince. Hi, Vince. And it's, what shape is this? A circle, correct. You can look like this, what is it? An egg? No, it's not my egg head. It's a oval. And whose name is on here? Oh, Shemaya. Hi, Shemaya. Whose name is this? Imran. Let's count the sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What shape is that? An octagon. And whose name is this? Hi, King. 1, 2, 3, 4 sides. Looks like a diamond, but what's the name of the shape? A rhombus. All right. Those are our shapes. We'll go, what's this? A cube. We'll go over some more shapes tomorrow. But before we go, you know what time it is? It's time to say, spell 9. Let's spell 9. 9-N-I-N-E. 9, room 9, the region's largest classroom.
Teaching in Room 9 is made possible with support of Bank of America, Dana Brown Charitable Trust, Emerson, and viewers like you.